Welcome. In this lecture, we will talk about some of the initiatives for higher education that took place during the pre-independence period. We will also focus about the major schools and colleges that were established during the British period in the forthcoming lectures. But here, our main focus would be why these initiatives of Christian missionaries started and what were the main areas where they were actually implemented, and also the early reforms that we would understand before independence. So to begin with, first of all, it was the madrasa education that started. Now, the madrasa education that started was originally with the establishment of Calcutta Madrasa in 1781, and the then Governor General Warren Hastings actually took personal interest in the establishment of these madrasas and laid the foundation grounds for the madrasas. Now, this initiative with Islamic education when gained popularity, there was an idea to open up institutions of higher education by various different agencies, and Christian missionary was one of them. So there was a series of effort that started in this direction, and we would be focusing on some of the major ones. So to begin with, in 1792, it was Jonathan Duncan, who was actually a resident of Banaras and established what was known as the Banaras Sanskrit College. However, this was not just one such example. During this period, different agencies, not just Christian missionaries, there were other Hindu learning centers also that established. For example, with the effort of Mount Strott Elphiston, there was the establishment of Pune College for Hindu learning. Later on, Raja Ram Mohan Roy established Hindu College, which is known as the present day Presidency College. This was established in 1870. Now, these efforts of the various agencies brought in individuals, even government officials and even businessmen into the field, and there were establishments of colleges. For example, in 1818, the Baptist missionaries established the college at Serampore. Now, this was a college which was established by a Christian missionary, and later on, 2 years later, there was a college which was founded in Calcutta to honor the Bishop Middleston, and this college in itself was a remarkable development because this Bishop Middleton was the first Anglican Bishop of India. Then there was the Bishop College, which was established at Shibpur in 1820, and this 1820 college that we are focusing on was established by the Church of England. Later on, there were colleges which were established by Scottish Missionary College. This was in 1830, and this was established by Alexander Duff. Now, for the education section, we understand that these are really important developments, and even the time point and the places, the names of the institutions established by whom, all of them become important. Now, there was a wealthy Muslim fellow. He established the Hooghly College in 1834. There were two colleges later on which was started in Bengal, and this was at Dhaka in 1835 and in Hooghly in 1836. Now, Boiwanipur, which is a suburb of Calcutta, was one of the places where missionary college was established, and this was by the London Missionary Society. Later on, there were specific colleges devoted to learning for European and Eurasian boys, and these were established in Calcutta. These were the Doughton College, La Maritrini Institution and St. Paul's College. So these three institutions were established specifically for the European and the Eurasian students. Later on, it was believed that with Wood's dispatch, which came into existence, there were series of colleges which were established, and these were highly different from the present day colleges. For example, we had college at Masulipatnam in 1841, at Nagpur 1884, Krishnanagar 1845, Bhairampur 1853 and Agra and again in 1853. So all these colleges established during 1800s were under the Woods Dispatch but were significantly different from the existing series of colleges. Now, some of the major developments that came in 1854, it was the Woods Dispatch, which was also known as the Magna Carta of Education. We have talked about this in a separate class in detail, but this